call to order 7:07 PM.
Anybody?
Second.
We have an agenda, right?
We do. Did you get the agenda?
It came by email.
Did you ask me if I printed it out?
Nope.
No, that's okay.
It's right here.
Okay.
So it's all right here. See if anyone typed at the same time. Okay, meeting minutes. So we just got the meeting minutes for last week, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And I only brought one copy with me.
Okay.
My printer's being funky, but they did go out like 15 minutes.
So can we defer meeting minutes to next week until we all have a chance?
Yeah.
Okay, let's defer the meeting minutes.
Okay. So Kelly's not here. Lester's not here. Roxanne's not here. Are we expecting Lester and Roxanne to show up?
I did not receive notification that they were not coming.
Okay. I just want to make sure I have it right for the minutes. Okay.
We have a couple stuck together. Okay, so the first agenda item was sport inventory. So we all saw the note from Kelly about the shape of the shed. And so we sort of handed that over to you, Dan.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. Basically, it seems to me that if I could get in there and if anyone else wanted to come and take a look at the stuff. And then, you know, thinking do it on a Saturday so the dump would be open. You know, I don't have a truck, but I have a kind of sort of a newfangled station wagon type vehicle that I use as a truck. And it's not that nice, so I don't mind getting it all locked up. So I can, you know, easily take a decent amount of stuff in the back of it over to the dump.
Yeah.
So we just kind of have to figure out a time. We'd have to do it on a Saturday, obviously, for the dump and so there aren't kids at the school.
Okay, so it's going to be coordination with the guy who opens it up too.
I guess it's not locked. It's
No, you just need a screw.
Just need a drill or a screwdriver. Yeah, it's screwed shut, I guess.
So they have a lock, right?
Well, yeah, right after that.
My understanding is that the doors came off their hinges, so they're just screwed in place. So we might need to.
We might need millions before we clean the shed.
What Saturday?
Well, maybe we can clean it and we can get rid of stuff.
But before we put more stuff in it, we want the building.
Exactly. We can at least, you know, we can take it off and then we can at least, you know, get rid of the stuff we don't want.
Okay, so do you want to, do we want to maybe look at the calendar and maybe choose a Saturday after on enough mornings or afternoons if that works for people?
I was going to say baseball, because now we're all like.
We're all baseball mode.
Yeah, yeah.
And Saturday, maybe after 5:00.
I mean, I could go.
Bill has his pickup truck, so I'm not worried about that. And he can also help with getting the doors, probably the hinge part of it fixed.
We have a truck too.
I might be able to.
So we're looking at you're looking for a padlock or like a number digit lock?
Well, maybe we should check out what the situation is probably. Like, I don't even know what these doors, what it looks like. So, I mean, I know I've seen the sheds, but I've never actually inspected them. So maybe we should get a sense of what it looks like first.
I only have one game on June 3rd.
And I don't have any games that day, as far as I know, because my son's doing Thursday that week. He's doing June 1st.
I might be, I mean, if I, even if just one other person came over, if Kelly could do it or whoever, you know, this coming Saturday, we have the opening ceremony in the morning at Marshwood. And then I think he has my son has a 2:00 game. But so in that window, I could probably at least, if nothing else, I can go over his look and see what else I can maybe try.
I could probably have Robbie come with me.
Yeah, just, I mean.
I don't know what Saturday's like.
And, you know, getting rid of stuff that's obvious, like it's broken, you know, I'm not going to go chucking a bunch of stuff. I don't want to, you know what I mean?
That's what Kelly said. It's so packed in there that she couldn't even tell what was working and what was not. So it might be.
You didn't organize it, you know, I can.
Maybe mad dragging. The other issue too is the fact that the roof on it is not a good roof. And whatever we put back in there or whatever we buy new and goes in there, it's going to get ruined if we don't get some tarps or something. Or even find a different storage area or something like that.
So we got to, all right, so assess.
The physical shed itself.
Yeah, and the stuff and just.
Yeah,
you
know, it is,
you get rid of the stuff that's obviously.
Yeah, I get rid of the junk.
See, you have left the rest of
and what was
nothing.
Your window?
Well,
this Saturday, this coming Saturday, I can, you know, sometime in the.
I go see
what's on the
list.
Yeah.
Probably like, I don't know, 10 o'clock or something. I could probably go over and,
and I told him anything else over.
Even if it takes an hour, you know, just to.
If I can make it over, I will. Chris has a game at 11:00.
Yeah, I mean, great.
I'm with you on opening ceremonies for Marshwood.
Oh, okay.
I said I have no game scheduled because we're in T-ball.
T-ball, yeah, they do that sometimes. Do they have an odd number of teams, probably? That's what they did
five,
this last year, rookie ball.
Five
yeah.
or six. Yeah.
It's kind of dumb. Like, okay, opening day and go home, you don't have a game.
Yeah.
That's a bit close.
All of they start the 29th, and then he has one Thursday night game, which is June 1st.
Right, yeah. Yeah, I don't know.
So Dan, if you take a look at it and decide that you need more help, or you want to organize another day, we can get plans together.
Probably do this initially,
check
it out, and then we can plan a day when more people can go and really tackle it, I guess.
Yeah, that sounds great.
But I can meet you.
Did you say 10
yeah.
o'clock?
Yeah,
no?
And I'll ask Robbie to come with me, and then we'll kind of try and get rid of what...
10 a.m. this Saturday?
Get rid of obvious stuff, you know, that's just like, you know,
29.
All nasty or whatever.
Yes.
So 10 a.m. the 29th.
And
that's by the softball field, right?
Yeah, there are two sheds, I guess. So I'll look for the one that is doesn't have the padlock and a screw shut, I guess. I could ask Kelly which one.
Well,
is
it's just screw shut.
Right.
They just
put a building permit in, right?
They just put a building permit in for a 30-foot concrete shed, so they're going to be doing that. It's supposed to be this week.
Oh, really?
So.
They're building a new one, huh?
They're building a new one for the school.
School.
So they're going to have a concrete shed. I think it's like 30 by 20 or something like that.
So
and it's going to be cinder block.
So are they taking what's in the two and...
No. It's just for the school.
Oh, I see.
And so that's the one that's like right at the annex doors, right?
I have no idea.
Do we know if they're demolished? They're going to plan on getting rid of the other?
I'm assuming. I have to.
So we're out.
Let's figure that out. Yeah, right.
No, you're not. They're not demolishing yours. They're paying their own because there's two there right now. I guess one's ours and one's theirs.
Okay.
They're just giving themselves a bigger one that's concrete. Okay.
So I asked them if they improved a lawnmower that they want to put in the shed.
That so maybe when you go, you can check out the door.
I mean, maybe even this week I'll go and meet my kids over there after school and just look at it and just get a sense. So I'll do that at some point.
I bet you weren't wearing at the pole. The way Kelly made it sound, she literally at the pole.
Yeah, she
I will wait till Saturday to do that.
I'll also get a letter from the board for you that you're from the rec department.
Oh, okay.
So anything you do have to bring to the dump, if it has to go into the dumpster
and
not paying for it.
Oh, right, to pay for it. That's a good point.
So I'll have them drop
the scrap iron.
I'll just leave it. I'll have them leave it here and you can pick it up.
Do you want to shoot me an email and just, or like when you have it or something, or I'll just come.
I will.
Just to tell me when you.
Oh, when it's
here.
Done. Yes.
Yeah.
I'm like, I don't think they'll take the email.
No. Just send me like if you send me an email. Say hey, it's just come by Tuesday and grab it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. All right. Thanks, Dan. So we'll do that. Okay. Registrations. So the number of campers, not including the pile I just got here, the number of campers total is 20.
Does that include committee kids?
Yeah. Doesn't include Dan's kids because I just got his registration.
22.
But it did include Jody's. Okay. So the number of campers thus far, not including the pile, is 20. So the total expected income based on those 20 kids right now is $6,121.
Okay, hold on.
And that's 20 kids, that's without Dan? 6,000.
Without
Dan's in this pile.
121.
And to put it into perspective, I can tell you what that covers. So that income covers the salary for the assistant director for the summer and Jordan's salary. So We need more children to pay for a director.
And that doesn't cover enough counselors to cover if we're doing 8 to 1.
Mm-hmm. We use another, if we're doing 8 to 1, depending on the number of kids, right? Or number of counselors based on the number of kids, I should say. That remains to be seen.
So
we should put a, another message on Facebook about the early bird.
Mm-hmm.
Coming up, yeah.
Did you get the pile from Kelly? She had come by and she had a couple, including on one or two that were out of town that she had picked up because we were here at the same time.
Was it a few weeks ago? Or was it last week?
I mean,
it was last week. I've not seen.
Trying to think. It was not this past Friday. It was the Friday before.
Oh, I think I didn't have that done.
The booking thing?
She said out of town?
Yes.
So I think all I have is Rollinsford right now.
Because she said, ooh, we got our first out of towners.
No, I've got all Rollinsford so far.
Okay.
No out of towners, but there is.
So she picked up something, she said that it might have been something.
Did any portal copy of the staff that you just got?
Rollinsford. That's Rollinsford. That's Rollinsford. See if there's anything here that I'm missing. That's Rollinsford. Rollinsford.
Maybe I missed.
Oh, her. South Berwick. Oh, it was Laura Jean. She's an out of town.
Mm-hmm.
Well, where's her? Here's her registration form. Anyways, so I've got that. So if it's them, then I have it.
And it might be.
Or I have this. So yeah, that's it. I'll have to look and see if I have it in here. Okay, so Lester had the next one, so we don't know what's going on there. Staff, Jody.
Yes.
Did you want to talk about?
Yes, we need to, in our excitement of hiring, we forgot to ask our hirees to fulfill their form for the background checks. So we have to for the background checks.
Mm-hmm.
So we have to ask them to go do that.
Mm-hmm.
So
we hired them without a background check, is what you're saying?
Yes.
Thankfully, thankfully, both of them were, one works at the school.
Details,
so,
details,
so,
right.
So, I don't think we should have a problem.
They just have to go down to the.
That's a good detail.
So, before the select board signs,
right.
Another yay.
So the offer letters going forward, though, will say there'll be a little blurb in there saying employment is contingent upon passing your background test.
Mm-hmm.
If you do not, then it's revoked. Your offer of employment is revoked.
I did talk to Kelly last week via email. And she said we had not received any applications for camp director and that we were still short on counselors. So Kristen made up these new ones that take out the assistant directors because the deadline also passed. The deadline had been April 15th. And since we are still accepting applications, these are new flyers to go out. I believe it's on the drive if you wanted to post it. And I dropped one off at Department of Employment Securities. They said they couldn't do anything unless they talked to the administrator of our account, who is Caroline. And that we have to do a job match thing Caroline has to do. But when I stopped to talk to Caroline about that, she said if we can get her a job description, like a paragraph,
mm-hmm.
with the wages, she can put it on Indeed.com for
yeah.
free.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay. Oh, it's not already there?
Not currently.
Oh.
So.
Is this updated on the website yet, the town website?
I don't know about that.
And so
we can check it.
Yeah, let's see.
Did you send it to you?
I'm not connected to the internet here.
So you're just forwarded it to the future.
Well, wait, doesn't Kristen have access to the website too?
So
yeah, she wanted to put it up, that's why I'm not sure.
Oh,
I have to check.
So I get confused between Tia and Kristen, who does what, but I think Tia wants to do this. She wants to be the one that posts all this information. Is that correct?
She usually does all the posting. They both have access to the web, though.
Okay.
From what I understand.
Yes. Tia is very proprietary about what she does and what she doesn't do. So
yeah.
Kristen has to tread very, very lightly if she's going to do something.
Oh.
So let's just send it to my master and update that.
And
possible.
If we send it to her as an attachment, she'll send it out as an email link, too. Or an email blast.
So we did get an application for a director.
Okay.
His name's Andrew Gray. He has a decent background. He worked for the Rochester Rep. And he works, and joining, I think it's probably on the weekends.
Yeah, he's also the head football coach for Farmington.
Mm-hmm.
And also works for special teams. Very impressive. I think graduated in 2014.
Yeah. You'll have to excuse me about that, but...
So he's probably 26.
He graduated from
Pepperdine
College in
2000. Yeah. Just recently came in.
Football coach, special needs,
yeah.
Aid, something else. Like he worked for kids.
Where does he live?
Farmington.
Oh, okay. So it's not too
mm-hmm.
far.
Yeah, his resume is right here. It won't go around.
Yeah, so it's promising.
So Kelly's talked to him. She sent us his resume to take a look at. He sounds like a great candidate to talk to.
Is this your note on here? Why jump to director?
Mm-hmm.
Just the, it pops on a resume and see director.
Mm-hmm. Sure
it might be nice to have, I mean, since we have a female assistant director, female, probably have predominantly female counselors, having a male, you know, it might be a nice mix. I mean,
mm-hmm.
you know, for the boys especially, we'll keep the boys in line, you know.
Yeah,
I agree.
Yeah.
We got one that does sports, one that does dance.
Science experiments.
And science, so.
That's right. You
they're
going to
be well-versed kids.
Programs, you know, good.
Talking about staff, I was approached by somebody who has a college student. He's a freshman in college, and he's looking for a summer job. Problem is, they don't want to have him apply because there's 1 week in July he's unavailable. And the flyer says, must be available all 8 weeks. Is it someone that we would consider if it's just a 1 week thing?
It depends. I'd like to see the resume to find out about his background.
We're coming down to crunch time.
CPR,
Did you say that?
Yeah. It's a little wet because we walked through read it in the rain during practice.
That's good news, though. It's
yeah.
Really good news.
Yeah.
I'm not saying you can hire this guy, but
he seems
at least we have somebody who's interested.
Yeah. Yep, so when Kelly gets back, we'll see if we can't set up some time with him to talk a little bit more about himself. Okay, so we'll have Tia, so to sum it all up, Tia will repost. We can get this on Indeed.com. We have to have Caroline do something with unemployment. Give unemployment permission.
Well,
anything else we can do? Is there? Does anybody want to consider Craigslist or anything like that? How would the town feel about something like that?
It's gone out to RGS, and Somersworth did have one flyer, but we can always go back to Somersworth and give it to the schools in there. We could. I went through when I did it through Somersworth. I went to the superintendent.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if somebody wants to contact this SAU, whatever Maine is, 56.
Maine is 35.
And see if anybody from the Marshwood District would want to.
Actually, I'm friendly with Nick's guidance counselor. I can at least start there.
Yeah.
Maybe just ask her if something like this was possible. How would I go about it?
Because they're having severe cutbacks there, so they might have teachers and stuff looking for part-time work.
Okay.
So.
And if for staff.
I say you may have said that it's okay, but we don't know if it got up at the teacher's mom's or going up by email, right?
Right. So I can go back tomorrow.
Sounds good.
Drop off flyers and say distribute to each of the schools and stuff like that.
Okay.
Well, you already have their approval. Just go in and say data for this. I say you already said okay, or do you have them?
Do we have anything staff related, anything further about our staff at some time? Okay, t-shirts, Celia, who we have t-shirts?
Okay. So far, I don't pass this around, it's two pages. We have 22 shirts ordered, not including the one I just received tonight. That includes the Nancy Chick one that came in this afternoon. And
so we're talking to the public ones.
The public ones. So there are 22 shirts ordered for a total of $228. The cost to the committee for the shirts is going to be $143, which means that we're making a profit of $85 on the shirts.
You said 208?
228. 20 is the total income paid. We are awaiting payment on three of these right now, and then the the rest of them have been payment received by either Caroline or one of the committee members. And next week we're going to go to What's the Scoop, and I will make sure I bring flyers, because I'll be there for a little while setting up the store committee, so I'll have order forms there too. We have order forms right now at the library and the town hall, and it's gone out via email and an email blast, and it's on the website. I don't know if and where we should put more. And we had them at town hall for town meeting, or town meeting day at the school, and then we'll have them at What's the Scoop. And open mills is May 6th and 7th. So I don't know if there is a good place or time to put them, flyers or order forms down at the mill. And then for campers, I only had 10 campers that had shirts so far. So evidently there's more campers that I haven't gotten reported for. And of those 10 campers, 6 are getting their shirts included in registration, and 4 are, I believe, siblings. They were registered together. So I need to get together with Dee and
yep.
figure out if they have actually paid their two shirts. Or
I can
one
in
there.
Yeah, I can tell you that after if you want.
Yeah.
But so I'll have more to give you. As soon as I get these recorded in, tonight or tomorrow, I can send you another list.
$7 for the extra shirt.
Seven, yeah.
So that would be like another $30 based on what we have there, 28.
So I have a question.
Yeah.
About shirts. So when is your deadline to get campus shirts in for the first day of camp?
Okay. So right now, yeah, I should bring that up. Kristen and I have been talking. The deadline right now is May 20th is what's on the thing, or 21st. And in order to get the, when people have been responding to us by email, I have a set thing that says your very last day to get your check-in is May 20th, but the sooner the better, so we avoid last minute confusion. And we will order extras in every size for the, and they will be in the week of June 12th, so the week before Father's Day, which gives us roughly 2 weeks, or give us a week or so in between times to get extra shirts if we need them. So once we get the shirts, they will have like the prints on the screens already ready, so it'll be a faster turnaround time, but we definitely need to order extra of all of the shirts. And then for like camper shirts, we need to determine how many in each size extra we want to get. Maybe at our next meeting, it's something to think about, because I don't know if we're meeting again before the order goes in.
Oh, it's May 7th, I think, May.
The Tuesday night.
May.
Tuesday.
Yeah. So we're, and then the next meeting might be the same. We might be putting the order in the next day. So we could do it at one of our next two meetings. Decide how many extra shirts in each size we want. And
May 9th, sorry, it's May 9th.
And then since they don't have a year on them, if we order too many of the camper shirts, they can be worn next year. That if we don't change the design, we have the same design next year, we can carry them over till next year. And then the other thing was that if we order extra and they don't all get used this year, then there will be extras for field trip days when kids show up without their shirts. They can have loaner shirts, or we get a last minute registration and they can buy a shirt right there.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yep.
And
okay.
Extras like things that need more than one, because they have two field trips and only one mom that does laundry, so.
Yeah.
So are they going to do it at the $7 rate? Because that was my question. Because I obviously have to buy an extra one like you do, but I want to buy so that they each have two. So do we go in and do this? Is it $7?
No, that's
for the other three.
For you, is
or
there,
are we going to charge us or families?
Is there
more?
Is there a place on the registration form for them to add in number of shirts needed? Because like if they want to order extra shirts and not just one per child, but like two per child.
I don't remember if I had that. I don't think so. I don't think I had that on here. Wait, is this in my book?
So my,
I don't think so.
My question is when we send out an email, should we send out an email to the parents who already have registered and say, just confirming you're getting X number of shirts, did you want to order extra shirts?
At this price.
At this price.
I can do that, because what I've done is I've gotten all the email addresses of the parents and put them together, and I'm trying to put together sort of like an email blast every 2 weeks just saying,
oh, that's great,
so many days coming, oh, you know. And so that's one of the things I can actually put in there, is just remind, if you need extra shirts, you may have only ordered one.
Yeah, so
you'll be getting one.
That was it. One of my questions in my email to you, is there a place for parents to note that they want extra shirts?
There is not on here, no.
So.
I'm sure we've covered this before, but the kids are only required to wear the shirts on the field trip days.
Just on the field trip days.
Other regular days, they don't wear the shirts.
No. Not unless I want to.
Are we upset with t-shirt talk?
That's as far as I know.
Yeah. So after we can take a few minutes and just go through this.
Do you want to chat about sponsorships and donations?
Okay. I have not received any more additional sponsorships from community events. However, I do have, this is what our sponsorship letter looks like. I have two copies of that. the three of us need to meet, so I'll talk to Kathy after and set up a time to go over the list that we got last time. We started a list of people that we should talk
sponsor
to.
Sponsor a child.
Or different businesses that we think we should talk to in the area and connect with. And at this point, the only donation that's come in is the C&J donation. For sponsorship and donations. However, I did, Kelly was able to talk to the president of REF, which is the Rollinsford Educational Fund that sponsors a bunch of things to the school, and they have agreed to help offset the cost of doodlebugs coming in this summer. We put the paper, so I got the paperwork from Kelly, and I gave it back to her, and she was dropping it off on Monday. So the application for REF has gone in, and I've talked to Doodlebugs about prime times and stuff, and Kathy and I need to meet and put that on the calendar.
So will that be one of those calendar items that are like the community, I forgot where I had it. Sorry, excuse me.
I got the times that were best ideal for her, so Kathy and I needed to sit down and talk about how it fit into the schedule.
Oh, so it'd probably be, is it the All Camp Arts and Crafts segment on Wednesdays?
Mm-hmm. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursdays, reading in the morning.
Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Okay, I put it on the notes.
Oh, so Wednesday afternoon.
We'll have to check with Doodlebugs again, because she said Mondays or Tuesdays are ideal for her.
Okay. And you can't Tuesdays, because it's the...
Right. So she said Mondays is what she usually goes into schools during the school year.
Yeah.
And she said she could start as early as 10 in the morning, and she'd run a program from... it'd be 30 to 40 minutes, but she's going to cap it at 40 kids. And then if there's more kids that want to participate, she'll run as... consecutive session following.
Okay, so we're going to be considering an all camp sort of thing. It's first come, first serve, so we'll have to figure out how to sign the kids up.
Well, she said it could be all camp, but it's going to be broken down into groups.
You have to do,
oh, I see what you're
right,
saying.
You can't do more than 40 in the first session.
Gotcha.
So she said preferably 25 max, because then she doesn't have to bring in a second set of hands. But she said you do up to 40 at a time, and she'll run them back to back. And she was hoping, since the first Monday would be the 28th, and then the second Monday would be the 3rd of July, which would be no camp anyway, to start the week after the 4th.
Okay.
If that would make sense. And that's why Kathy and I want to sit down with you and
sure.
put it on your calendar and give you all the details.
Yeah.
And then it was... Kelly looked at the information, and I can forward you the information too if you don't have it already, about a 4-week program versus a 5-week program for Doodlebugs. And that way it would go to like the first or second week of August.
Mm-hmm.
And then if we wanted something they could special the last week, she would be done.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Kathy, did I send you the calendar, the weekly schedule?
This one?
Yeah, did I send it to you for all weeks?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll send it to you for all weeks so that you can take it and have it, and then
oh.
you can just start mocking it up.
Oh, okay.
And you can give it to me at every meeting, and I'll just make sure that the calendar that I have gets updated.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Sure.
So I think that's what I have right now for... sponsorship and donations.
Okay.
I've now got a handle on the t-shirts, so I'm ready to move in with Kathy.
Yeah, I think now that you have this letter, because, you know, we can go door to door. I don't want to go door to door, in Rollinsford, but you have to have something to say this is really who we are and we want your money, so. but yeah, that would be great.
My question, though, as I'm thinking about it now, was since we have money in the budget, we've brought in some money already, can I go to Staples and have them make like 50 double-sided copies of this and then have them like really nice copies and then distribute them that way?
Oh, you can just send it to me and I can send them for free.
Okay.
You want to do that?
Sounds good.
Send it.
I believe.
Free sounds awesome.
That was the best idea.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah. It may not be like great paper. It'll be like this, but it's okay as long as it's, printed for free.
Yeah.
That's all we care about.
Well, as I was leaving, I'm pretty, my husband's having a heart attack about my ink costs, and I'm like, get over it, get over it.
Yeah, just send it to me, and I'll get it printed up. Get it back.
It's a purchase order for ink.
Okay, so we're all set with sponsorships and donations.
Yeah.
Is Roxanne going to be helping?
I hope so. So I was hoping to talk to both of them tonight and set up a date that we could sit down and do a, like a subcommittee meeting, and get started on that, get it done.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm pretty flexible, so.
So I'll talk to her and we'll send out an email to Roxanne and see if she can come.
Okay. All right, so Kathy, you're up next. You've got, I realize that you have three segments, so if you need any help from anybody,
I will
just make sure you
reach
ask
out. Them. Yeah, but right now it's kind of not too busy. So for community talent and community service, I talked with Kate this past Wednesday, and she said that she has a meeting with Roxanne this coming week to talk about, I asked her about the garden, and she told me that she will, when she meets with Roxanne, she'll know from the construction company where a safe place to put it would be. But we definitely could have one. So I'll follow up with that. And I think she said that Miss Wright usually gets it starting. So, I guess that she usually gets it started, so then it'll be something we can help maintain it. But I was hoping that, you know, we could offer to, you know, make the red raised beds if we wanted a little bit bigger. Could we elaborate on that? So that is the scoop there. And I left a message with Mary Pratt over, this is a different topic, I guess, so over at Foster's, to see if we could be part of the community calendar, where they make that big page, because it is free. And we need to be a part of that. So I'm going to keep on here. I'll call her again tomorrow, so that we're in there.
Okay.
And then... another, for a talent, for someone to come in, I talked with my son Robbie about Explorer coming in. They drew a presentation for the 6th through 8th grade, because you have to be 8th grader to join the Explorers, but 6th grade they can start getting the wheels turning, you know? And so that, to come in and do a presentation, and so he said that whenever's good for us, you know, they can come in 1 or 2 days.
Okay.
So that would be good. And
Robbie's a fire explorer, right?
Well, he's a firefighter. He was one of the first explorer groups in town when Officer Spinney started it up. And so that, he was going from mechanical engineering group, and that just kind of changed his whole career path. And, you know, Rollinsford pays for your training, so if it's someone that's interested in, you know, it could be, get their wheels turning with that. So, then I wanted to talk about the ice skating rink. Is that okay too? I still have not heard back from Tia. I sent her an email asking what we can do to help, and she's gotten reimbursed for, and haven't heard back. Robbie rolled up the liner, took down all the boards. They they did a group at the fire department, and then Robbie rolled up the liner and it's sitting on the side there. And somebody told him that it's all up to the rec now. So
what's up to the rec? To take care of the liner?
Where to store it?
Where to store it. And so
Mike asked at the select board's meeting about it, and I said that you had was emailing Tita about it because he had seen it still lying out there. I mean, I'm guessing Monday, I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
But by the time I got home from my meeting, there was a Facebook post thanking the firefighters for taking care of it. From the ice rink has its own Facebook page.
I know that.
Yeah. So, and it said thank you to the firefighters for taking care of it. So, we have to find a place to store this now.
Uh huh.
How and heavy is it?
Oh, very
heavy. I would think it's.
Robbie said he said. Yeah. That's what he said to Jeff was to possibly have it stored at the town barn. Like if he could come down and pick it up with his thing and then drive it down to the town barn.
It's gonna have to sit off the ground.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's gonna need pallets.
Or Robbie also mentioned that there's a place above in the fire station that he could put the forklift in. And he thought there was storage up there. But So I
wouldn't trust the weight of it.
I just thought that we have to decide what's okay, where it goes.
Yeah, I'll bring it up at the.
Do you think is it still outside now? Yeah, it's still sitting there.
It's rolled up.
But now it's been rolled up and exposed to rain, so it'll be molding when we open it up next year. Right? I don't know. I know what happens with my stuff when
But maybe if it's so heavy and dense, maybe that not a lot of water has been able to infiltrate.
Yes. Okay, so
even if the firefighters did, I'm sure it's nice and tight.
So, Joe, you want to ask the select board where we could store it? Is that
because Jeff's going to have to okay it. We have to have Jeff okay the time to do it because that's not
his usual job.
Right. So, you know, if she's donating it to rec, right? Then, but I have no confirmation of that.
Right.
And all I have is hearsay.
If you haven't, so she hasn't received payment yet, as far as you know?
She hasn't put in for it, and at this point, she bought it before the beginning of the year, so I don't know how that would work. That would be a select board decision.
Okay.
Because we put it in this year's budget, not in 2016's budget. She bought it in 2016 rather than January 1st.
I see.
So the purchase order would be off, and our accountant would be really upset.
Mm-hmm.
Whether we can fix that, that's not my decision to make. That's the select board's decision to make.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I don't have any confirmation that it's ours.
Mm-hmm.
It's not ours. We didn't buy it. So I'm more than happy to store it as a person, but it's not our property until we get confirmation that it's our property.
And Tia's not going back to you.
No.
Okay.
No, it's just a little awkward.
Do
you want me to send her a note and ask?
Sure.
Okay.
But the firefighters rolled it up for us and they said we just need to place it somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Are we allowed to leave it at the fire station right where it is on pallets with a blue truck over that?
I think
another question for tomorrow?
I think that there's room in the fire station.
I mean, it would make a lot of sense that we don't
to
put it back.
Inside and the outside.
Even if there was a place, I don't know what it looks like behind the fire station, but even if we were to put it on pallets behind the fire station with a tarp over it.
Right, yeah.
You know, just to get it out on a, thankfully it's so heavy that difficult to steal it.
Yeah, you can't steal it, no.
Kelly just sent me a text. She's drinking rum right now.
Oh, I believe it. She's probably
good time. I told her, you suck. And she wrote back, huh.
I should take a big pan out of this rum and send it to her.
Oh, gosh. Seriously, Kelly.
I asked why she, and maybe it
you'll get your answer tomorrow at town meeting, if he had room for all of the vehicles that he was going to be getting in. And he said that they have an extra bay, so I don't know if they're filling. But would it be in the way or whatever?
Yeah.
All right, so I'll send a note to Tia and Jody will find out what we have available to store or where to store it, right? Or if Tia actually wants it back. I have no idea what's going on.
Right, we don't know.
Is that all we have on community talent and community service, 6 or 8?
I do have a question. So for community service, maybe we can do things like contact Tamara at the library to find out if there's any projects that she needs to have done. Maybe the kids can go in there, even if it's reorganizing books for her or moving books around or items like that. The school, I don't know if the school has anything, because you know they're moving classrooms now.
Right.
I don't know if, as part of community service, if maybe Kate would need some help. Of course, not anything where they're lifting anything heavy or it's going to cause any sort of injury, but anything easy that the kids can do,
right.
I would consider it to be community service, I guess.
And then the garden club, too, there might be some stuff that they need done.
Yeah. And again, if you need any help, please don't.
I'll reach out.
Don't hesitate.
Yeah. So I'll check with Tamara.
It's actually Sarah McClain, is the director down there.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
I have her email if you want to.
Oh, sure.
So
camp activities, I know that that's something that as soon as we get a director, he's going to, you know, hopefully take the ball and run with it.
Mm-hmm.
And the assistant director.
And I didn't know if you want to consider this, but we could have a mascot. I have a turtle that I'd be willing to bring over for 8 weeks. We're in the aquarium, he's like this big. And you can walk him around, and so I don't know, it's a red-eared slider. I don't know, that would be like a project.
Sounds like you're offloading a turtle for 8 weeks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll supply the tank, the turtle, and the food.
Are you worried about it getting it back?
That's my concern, too, like, what if something happens?
Oh, that's fine. Perfectly fine.
Clearly we're trying to get rid of it.
We have to probably ask Kate. I don't know if she'd want it there.
Yeah.
I mean, that's something that we'd want to probably clear with her.
Yep.
Just to be curious.
What did they do with the bunny that Miss Wright had?
I didn't know they had a bunny.
Yeah, they did. For
there was a bunny in that for
kindergarten room, when she was in kindergarten room.
Ooh. I wonder if she'll bring it back. And don't they hatch eggs, too?
The turtles?
Bunnies or turtles?
No, the bunnies. The little chicken eggs. Remember she did the...
Miss
Wright did. So a turtle would sound a little cleaner than what's already been in there.
Are they, though?
There's some filled
heard
bacteria.
That, I've heard that turtles are kind of... Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I'm not a turtle owner anymore.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
well,
they can be more disgusting than they can, so...
But I've definitely read some things where, like, turtles are like, maybe it's not such a good idea to have a turtle. You know?
I won't let James have one, honestly.
But that
because
purpose.
There's some gross.
Any
and he's
just
actually
they, yeah, I mean, they just,
all
they,
all
they three, they
yeah.
just...
Yeah, that's a good point.
So.
Like, But you can, you know, you can touch them and then wash your hands.
Yeah, that could get a little crazy. I like the idea, but
yeah.
Just for that purpose alone.
Maybe I could bring him down for a visit, maybe.
And there's also stuff on the drive about bringing in Seacoast Science Center out of Rye,
mm-hmm.
where they would bring in lobsters and stuff.
Ocean crabs.
If we can get our ducks in a row and get the money, we could bring them in. Or Wildlife Encounters out of Rochester, too.
They can bring in the lobsters and then apparently take them home for dinner.
So if you wanted to ask Kate,
sure.
And then we can, once we get a director, we can maybe ask him.
Sure.
If that's something that, or her, excuse me, or her, if it's something that we would be interested in doing. Yeah, she says it's 80 degrees there.
Somebody's
not that. Kathy, can you just get your email down right there?
You chose not to participate.
I'll send her an email.
So don't.
You chose.
Community service.
Yeah.
Did we talk about?
I'm sure I probably got an email from one of these other ones.
The other day about the drug testing?
We just take the background check.
Thank you.
Yeah, we hired him without forgetting to ask to go downstairs and talk to the police.
Okay.
If my text not come through.
Okay, so we can move on. Anything more about camp activities?
Nope, that's all I got.
Okay, staff orientation and training. Elin, Joey, do we have anything to talk about there?
Nope. We can table that for them.
Sounds great, thank you.
Okay, RGS facility, that was Rock Sand, onsite inspections, Dana.
I'm willing to do that.
Do you want to do it for all of us, on behalf of all of us?
I mean, like I said, like last time, I'm around a lot in the summer, so I mean, I don't have any problem shooting over there.
Joey, does the select board want to be involved in that too? Does maybe Suzanne want to, no?
If I could report back, then.
Nope.
I mean, I don't know what I, you know, until we start, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think just walking around, you know, just making sure everything's okay.
Yeah, no, you know, and I don't want them to feel as though, you know, they're under the microscope either, I mean, because, I mean, I'd be willing to, you know, if they're doing some sort of a, you know, intramural sport type thing or whatever, hang out, so I mean, I'm hoping to have it be sort of informal, but also I'll take a look around and stuff.
Okay.
So, a spy, basically.
No.
You'd be a spy.
Okay, that's it. So now we have an open forum. Is there anything anybody needs to talk about or bring up? Questions, concerns, comments?
I like the system. I think it will be much more efficient, you know. Before it was kind of just bouncing all over the place, so it's good.
Did I bring up the check-in and check-out process? It's not gonna, like, as a parent, like, the first week, yeah, this is Zoe and Zach, and, like, sign, but, like, come week two or whatever, hi, like, you're the checking person, hi, yeah, Zoe and Zach are here, we'll see you later. And they just check it off. We're okay with that, right? We don't expect the parents to walk in and go, Zoe's here, Zoe's signed out.
As long as we have the right
the normal people that picking them up. Like if my mother picks them up.
Oh, yeah, so for a license, is that, I know I missed one or two meetings in between our discussion of it to today.
Yeah.
So how much of a, like, physically signing them?
I think, just an idea, having the same employees doing that every morning, like that's their job, you know what I mean? Just to have control over that, like just not having,
are you initialing them in, or are you just having them say, yep, Zoe and Zach are here?
That's just it.
Yeah.
Yeah, like the counselor is the one that would initial that Zoe and Zach are here, and then saw the parent drop them off.
Or an adult figure.
Right.
Saw a parent drop them off. But how's that anything different? Because remember in the beginning, we were at odds, not, I shouldn't say at odds, excuse me, I don't mean that. How we were in discussion over, well, why can't the kids just walk themselves?
Right.
So how is that going to be any different then?
Because the counselor actually sees the
parent. They have to physically see the parent?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you still have
or the person on the sheet.
They still have to get out of the car. And
yeah, I think that whoever's doing the check-in, check-out process, and I think it should be the same counselors every day.
Keep it consistent.
Exactly. I think that the kids need to know that they have to go still to the check-in, check-out table.
Right.
Regardless of the parents waving, you know, they still need to,
right.
Still need to go. That's my opinion.
Usually dropping the littler ones, you're still bringing in all their stuff anyway. Gear and water gear.
The only issue that I have with that, and I know that we're going to have good staff, and if it is the same person checking them in all the time, because that was an issue before. the staff didn't really know the person's name and checked him off anyway. So I was like, that's not Jeremy, this is Anthony.
Good point.
You know, so I think that the parent has to sign him in.
Okay.
So like a daycare?
Yeah.
Is it daycare, that's what you have to do as a parent?
Yeah, like at the works.
In a clip book, you turn to that page and you sign your initial in.
Yeah.
I agree. It's in the handbook anyways.
So you have to change it out every day. The papers.
Okay, so. I mean, I agree with what you're saying.
Small,
they do want
to
sign
small
in
price
in
to
time.
Pay for having
so they're initially
in time,
I guess.
Yeah.
Time in and out.
I think they should. For sure. That's something that when the director comes on, we can ask.
You just put the book in alphabetical order by last name and first name. Mm-hmm.
Agree.
I'm having happy helper flashbacks right now.
Yeah.
With possible date and time? Or possible time? Is that what we're discussing?
Yeah, we're talking about date and time, And they will have.
You won't have to put date, you know why? Because if you have a sign-in sheet each day,
right,
like a booklet that you. You basically take the papers out of your counselor or whatever does it. You just have it by last name, first name, and you initial in the time that they were signed in, and initial in the time that they left by parent. That's basically what you do.
That's the way I had it set up. I just can't find it right now.
And so that would be good, too, because then, like, whoever's doing the sign out, sign in for staff can send them directly to the counselor that's assigned to them. It's like you're going to such and such a person, and if that person's for some reason like sick that day, you're going to.
And honestly, you're going to have a whole summer's worth. So when you go and prep for the next year, you're going to be able to see how many of the early bird people truly utilize that early opening versus different times, and you can see kids coming in and out when they leave,
and
so you can gauge times for the. Following the year, if you do it like that. I mean, I know it's only one summer's worth of stuff, but if you think about it and you do it like that, you're going to see it over time, how to gauge staffing and stuff like that.
And you're going to...
a smart move on our part if we do go that route.
And I'm thinking from my perspective, you're going to see which parents didn't get into the... or which families weren't able to get into the... early bird because they didn't get their registration in town, and like they're being dropped off by somebody else, or they're being dropped off by right on the dot when the door's open, and then we'll know.
I think it actually set us up for pre-planned come 2018.
Mm-hmm.
That's just me.
Okay.
So, question, are we going to continue every 2 weeks throughout the summer, or are we going to go to a monthly basis, or as needed, or
we'd have to have everybody here to make that decision, but in my opinion, probably not every 2 weeks. Okay. Maybe stretch it out a little bit.
Because I think maybe...
check-ins, pulses to see how things are rolling.
I think maybe if we do once a month, then we can... keep a tab on Summer Rec, but also talk about other programs that we want to get going.
Right, because we're not just, I have to remember, we're not just Summer Rec.
So, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's
coming up.
And like, Kathy's got the ice rink, and like, if I want to, and come at the end of Summer Rec, we're going to start thinking about budget, probably.
Yeah, that's due to the town, I think it's such, oh boy, I have had that down somewhere.
September 1st, I said. I can lease on that.
So maybe we meet every 2 weeks just to make sure we have cash flow going through the summer and be ready for budget season.
Oops. September 30th.
So basketball's the only thing we have to worry about outside of summer left. What else do you think?
I don't remember
that
one.
Skating rink, basketball, and summer left.
And then I want to start in 2018 some elderly programs.
But the basketball, there's a group of people who kind of, they did some open gyms this past winter. They didn't have a team this year that fell through, but they had some open gyms, and there's a group of people that are that are.
Girls or boys this year?
No.
Cassie is the person that's supposed to get back and forth to the board on stuff like
yeah.
that.
So I mean, that's definitely. I don't think it's falling on us to run the whole basketball.
Oh, okay.
No, they just have to. They're a subcommittee of us.
Cassie
is the one that reports back, and when we asked for an update, they just said that they same thing, that they started too late, they couldn't get you together. So.
But it was good. I mean,
just in the,
you know, my kids played a bunch of times, and it was fun. It was just like they did it a couple times a week and
night.
Yeah, and they opened the gym and they ran some drills and played scrimmages and even if they don't have a team, I mean, at least it gets kids out moving around and
all
that. You know,
Family
so.
Fun Day also falls under summer record, but
mm-hmm.
they're their own 503C and it's run by Denise Knowles, and she's an alternate for this committee.
Yeah, they're not at summer Fun Day, is it?
Family Fun Day.
Yes.
Say that again.
Family
There's
Fun
two
Day.
Different ones?
No.
No.
Oh, okay.
Just
the one that's with me.
Yes. No, Family Fun Day is a 501c3 that is Denise's that the town donates to.
So how did they become a nonprofit?
She created a nonprofit.
She did?
Just fill out the paperwork with the IRS. Anybody can make something a nonprofit.
Mm. So winter rec basketball.
We'll get clarification on the ice rink. Because do we want it as a
we have to find out if it's ours, right? Then it's been given to us.
Yeah, is it a town thing that we're gonna do now? Or
who's responsible?
Right.
For what?
Like, because next year we can put in a budget for shovelers for the ice rink.
Well, there's $1,100.
So, but that was for the liner.
But we haven't seen any receipts or anything to pay out, right?
But we didn't buy the liner, right? It was Tia?
Tia bought it in 2016. Has not submitted the... We did just talk about this because it's flying out of my mouth now.
Yeah.
Right, okay, so...
She hasn't submitted the receipt. She isn't returning phone calls or an email or whatnot.
Right, and I was going to contact her. But
I
so they did put the money back in the budget in case she submitted the receipt for it.
We haven't taken it out of the budget.
Okay.
Because it was supposed to be in this year's budget.
Okay.
It only got approved in March.
When did she buy it?
2016.
Right. Okay. Oh. All right. Mm-hmm.
Now you're with us. You're picking up what we're throwing down.
Yeah.
So interesting.
Well, it's because he looked at the numbers.
It's the liners. Is this our department?
So what happens to the money?
Like, from what I understand, the fire department has been doing a lot along with Tia and her husband, which is absolutely wonderful.
Tia and her husband, this was kind of their thing.
I don't want to take it away to know if it's there.
So should we have
But just like a little... I know some other information that now Tia's two kids are going to be playing hockey, so maybe they're not going to be quite as interested in doing the outdoor rink. This was they got this thing going before their kids started playing hockey, and now they're going to be playing hockey.
So they're going to be
full
busy.
On. So I mean,
as you know,
that could be her saying, "Okay, I'm just guessing. I'm just guessing."
So is there anything within this town that would be considered something that we think that the kids will want to do as far as leagues are concerned? We've got basketball.
There used to be a softball team
right.
back
right.
in the day, and they Sudamoyan actually ran it. And they went to championships and stuff like that. Because I remember all of it when I was in grade school, which was many moons ago. But there used to be a softball team.
Because doesn't the school do a softball, intramural softball thing? That's what I'm thinking of.
I don't know if they're going to do it.
But that was not that long ago, right?
What about Sproul? Southport with Elliot.
That's the thing. I mean, we're such a small town.
I can tell you about
the kids are, I mean, I mean, my son plays Marshwood baseball, plays Rochester hockey. I mean, it's just, so I just don't think we have enough kids in this town to be able to do a full-on league. Could be wrong, but I don't know. There's so many other options that are right there.
With the after-school intramural softball, it actually hurt the leagues around us because parents were signing their kids up for the after-school softball and not for the leagues. So we have the Summers of Bronzeville League and we have the Sprell League. This one plays by Babe Ruth rules, this one plays by Little League rules. So those leagues are diminishing as well. Kids are just not playing as many sports because more parents are working and having a hard time getting them to practices.
Lacrosse
is taking up spring basketball, a spring soccer, and AAU basketball also cuts into the baseball time and softball time. But the numbers are down. They're really low. So in both leagues. So, but they do have options. They have lots of options. And they also go to Dover as well, and they even play by Cal Ripken. So there's lots of options there for the kids to play. Boy, girl, from four to...
My daughter, she played on the Rawlsford travel basketball team for 2 years, and then in half, she played the Marshwood Rec League. They had games on Saturdays, I think, and like one practice a week, and it was fine for her. She's not that into it, so it was a perfect fit, you know, in that sense. I mean, they've done the basketball, there seems to be some interest, you know. I think if anything, that might be the way to go if you wanted to have a team. I mean, it was a pretty successful program for a while. It's just the folks that were running it anymore, and no one was able to kind of pick it up. I figure they could, soccer, they had the Rosso soccer has been going for a really long time. Mm-hmm. And the Marshwood soccer is pretty good, so I don't know.
Yeah, we just signed my boys up for soccer.
In the spring session?
Yeah, in Marshwood. Yeah. Or soccer with Rex. But you know something I don't see in this community that I know they do at Noble? And thanks to Jody, I got my first peek at it earlier this year, is a ski bus. What would be wrong with renting like a first student bus on a Saturday to meet like
ski bus, I see.
Like here at the town hall or at the post office and take people up to like Gunstock or Pat's Peak for the day.
They do that though in Marshwood already. They have this, you can sign up.
Okay.
They do it discounted on
I think some of them
are
like
too,
right? Oh, I should do this.
They do
it
in
Rochester.
In some sort.
Yeah, I do things like that too.
Yeah, because like I took my boys to King Pine,
and you can actually get tickets. Your parents can go because Bill was like, "Do you want me to go?"
No, because I think about I enjoy what we're doing. We do, considering the size of the community, we do have a load of work to do, especially now it's somewhere after minutes, but. What else can, is there something else that we can sometime in the future offer something different?
But I hear you say that Marshwood has it, but do the, I was thinking.
It's offered to our students because we're part of that school system.
But I'm wondering if it's something we should offer to the whole community.
Summersworth does that out of their Parks and Recreation too. They do I'll get a newsletter about trips, they plan trips for families. Red Sox trips, just all a bunch of
The police
association.
Yeah, they do a trip to Fisher Cats maybe, or Sea Dogs perhaps.
Maybe sometime down the road we can think of doing things like that.
Yeah, there might not be a bad idea.
Well, you are a Parks and Rec committee, so maybe next year we can think about making sure there's benches in our parks.
Yeah.
So, and I have no idea the shape of the gazebo over by the river. I never go down there. So.
It gets vandalized frequently.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah.
So maybe that could be a new surface.
And then when we had our
that's true.
Meeting,
yeah.
We talked about putting
that's
doggy bags for the
at the beginning of the
There's
wall.
Another gazebo. You mean the gazebo near, like, go near Fogarty's? That gazebo or the
Which
Legion
gazebo?
Gazebo?
Because I think the one at the Legion is owned by the Legion.
Yeah.
No, I mean the one by the river.
Yeah.
The one
does,
across the wall.
That does get That does get hit. There's, I don't know why, but, yeah, I've seen it been through there. It's all
and
nervous.
Speaking
That's
from, if I change over here and speak about my historical committee for a minute, we are looking at refurbishing a couple of buildings down the line, and one of them would be a gazebo-like building, and it was at the mill at one point, so we're going to be meeting with the people at the mill, see if we can put it back down at the mill, and or at, if it's okay with the town, putting it at Morton Park or next to the fire station if the people at the mill don't want it back. So that
happens at the mill, you gotta wait for the retaining wall to be
finished. Yes, well, this is a long-term project, it's gonna cost a lot of money.
It's a gazebo that exists, or
it's
a build a gazebo?
It was a pump house that was at the mills that was put along the river, so then the fire department, if it had another, this came up probably around 1900, after one of the mills burned, they built a pump house so that they could get water quickly to the mills. And at some point in the last 10 or 15 years, it was moved when work was done there, and the water department called up a longtime resident of the town and says, would you mind coming and taking this to your home so it doesn't fall into the river, because it's about to?
So some private citizen has this,
in
this
their
pump house in their backyard?
And they would like to have it refurbished and put back at the mills or someplace prominent so it doesn't get vandalized. So I think if we're thinking about parks and rec, that is something to think about, is like vandals and working with other groups in the community.
Who does the town own the softball field next to the police, the fire station?
The cemetery owns it, actually.
Oh, okay.
And they let Sproul use it.
Right.
So, and Sproul maintains it.
But it's a situation where any town person can use that. It's not like
as
it's,
long as Sproul isn't using it.
Right,
or
but I'm just saying
at the moment,
anybody. It's a public.
But
anybody
it's a
can
public
go and
park
use it. Right.
Owned by.
Right.
The cemetery. So the cemetery, when if and when they need it, they'll
right.
take it over.
But if there's not like a practice or game going, anybody can go and use it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think the only rule is no dogs allowed on the field, like any other baseball player.
Right.
Good.
Now I don't feel guilty.
Yeah. And the Legion owns the softball field
right.
for them. And from what I understand, there used to be a softball field on top of its own. Over here by Locust, but that's this year was the first year I've ever heard of that. So I don't know. So I have to walk over there and take a look. First day I heard of that.
And then there's the softball field at the school, right? And that's available to anybody?
That's the school's property. So
okay.
They don't
I think they
I know
we played a couple of years ago, they had baseball practice there.
Yeah.
It was used as one
yeah,
of the rotations.
Sproul uses it? Okay, because I know...
What
was
Sproul?
Rollins for Elliott Little League.
Yes, that is exactly what happened.
When I used, and when I asked for someone to borrow Rollins for softball, they said no. So it's just not a field that we play. Because so, we were looking for practice spots.
Mm.
So. But that might be because Sproul uses
like
it.
We played Dilton last year, so it was the year of...
I think we played you guys there.
That's
actually.
When I'm like,
it was a rookie ball game.
I remember
yeah.
seeing Shane there.
Yeah, Shane. I think one of your boys and Shane might have had a great collision at the plate in that game.
That would be Emmett.
I think Shane.
Because Emmett usually catches.
Shane was catching, and I think Emmett ran into him at the plate. Yeah, I don't know. Anyway, it was excitement.
Celia, question. You were talking about doing something with Elderly. Are you looking at that as being part of the Parks and Rec?
Yes, seniors. And actually, if we go, the planning board has a, they're in charge of the 10-year or 20-year plan, whatever it is, for the town, and they have on their website, through the planning board, something for community rec, And it says right in there that the seniors are underserved in this community.
What's the population of seniors here in the community?
Well, we know that our enrollment's down at the school, so that shows that.
We have a quite high elderly population, and I'm going to break the fourth wall because Vern probably knows. Vern, would you know that number off the top of your head?
No, off the top of my head, but I know it's in the census numbers.
Yeah, I know we're quite high. Yeah, over 65 is quite high in this community because, and we have a lot of veterans, more so than many towns. So
like in, for the 2018 budget, I'd like to put a small line in. Once we get Summer Rec up and running, then we could offer programs to the seniors starting in 2018.
I think that's a great idea.
I think right now we've got our hands full with starting a monthly.
And I do bring it up, but I work at assisted living facility one day a week, and I need a copy of their activities calendar because I thought that, like on the rainy days, we could do some of their activities, like the
bingo for chocolate.
Yeah, they play bingo, but the hangman and the mind games and headlines and horoscopes, and I think that like when it's rainy outside, we need more indoor. I can give this to the director or assistant director, and they can. Yes. Do you know if we have a, I think the older people and the younger people, like that parachute, do you know if we have one in the rec?
The school used to have one. Are you talking about where you put the belts and you flip it up and then you go underneath it?
Yeah.
Is it fun?
God, we used to use that.
They use it for older people as well.
I believe Kate gave me a couple of catalogs ordered from. And I passed them off to Kelly, but there should be some different companies that we could look at if we get enough money to invest in things like that.
Because the activities people there, they I don't know what website they go to, but like April 26th is National Pretzel Day, and like the 27th is Pampered Dog Day. So they always theme the activities around that day. Can I see that? Oh, sure. It was huge, so I just kind of made a copy. But 80 years old, 8 years old, all about the same.
There was recently a Facebook article or an article online about mixing them, and quite a few of my friends are really excited. They're like, where can we find this? We want to mix our kids with, like, it was, I think, a preschool and an elderly assisted living facility, and talking about how that is such a great combination because the adults are very caring and want to take care of the kids, and the kids are very like mindful and perceptive and stuff like that. And even if they have dementia, they can be at the same level at some point.
Right. Or some that have Asperger's, you know, that are focused on the war or whatever. Sit next to a veteran and it's like they hit it off. It's wonderful.
Well, I think that's a great idea. Do we have anything else? Any other questions, comments, concerns, feedback?
Not from me.
No. Motion to adjourn, 8:28.
I will motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
You might want to send a text to Kelly and take a picture of the clock.